Welcome to the 5th MATLAB Arduino tutorial. This video will cover threshold crossing. We will be using the same hardware setup from the second tutorial. Now that we can read and filter sensor data, it may be useful to measure the number of times the accelerometer signal crossed a given threshold. The task can be split into three cases. First, the signal crossed the threshold for the first time. Add 1 to a counter and note that the accelerometer signal is above the threshold. In the second case, the signal remains above the threshold. No extra coding is necessary. In the third case, the signal falls below the threshold. We only need to note that the signal is below the threshold. Let's look at sample MATLAB code for the first case. Before the while loop, initialize the variable's threshold value to a desired level, step count in is high flag to 0. Step count will be used as a counter, and isHigh flag will be used to note the state of the signal in reference to the threshold. In the while loop, use an if statement to test if the last value of the accelerometer reading was above the threshold and if it was below the threshold before. Alternatively, the last filtered value may be used instead. Increment the counter and change isHigh flag to 1. A similar conditional statement and appropriate code can be added for case 3 here. Run the magnitude.m script created in tutorial 3 to visualize threshold crossing. I have set the step count variable to display in the text box above the graph. With thresholding just below 1, my counter correctly increases each time I turn the accelerometer to align the x-axis with gravity. Raising the threshold greater than 2, I can only count the highest peaks when I jerk the accelerometer. There's an interplay between thresholding and filtering. The previous demonstration was done using low filtering. Increasing the number of taps to 20 and heavily filtering the signal, I may not even be able to reach the current threshold. Lowering the threshold to less than 1 and turning the accelerometer, I would have to keep the x-axis aligned with gravity longer or lower my threshold to reach the signal. Thank you for watching. Please visit matlabarduino.org for more videos.